Hello guys, this is Shreya and I welcome you in my channel Shreya Knowledge Hub. Guys, today I will tell you that how to create a SEO friendly blog post on WordPress. Guys, I will tell you everything related to blog post creation on WordPress. Like, I will tell you how to make use of H1, H2, H3 tags in your blog post, how you should optimize image to make it SEO friendly for your blog, how to make use of keywords, title and description in your blog post, and how to make use of tags. Guys, I will tell you everything related to SEO friendly creation of blog post on your WordPress. But guys, if you want to know completely about it, so please be with us till the end of this video. Because guys, if you will leave this video in the middle, then you will not be able to learn everything completely and it will create a confusion for you. So guys, please be with us till the end of this video. Guys, I will tell you everything while working on my client site or on live project, because it will give you a very practical experience. When you will also work on your client's project, it will be very beneficial for you. So guys, this is the site of my client. Their company name is Herb Nainital and they have their resort in Mukteshwar, Nainital, and they provide the membership of their resort. So guys, today I will tell you everything while working on his site. So guys, here in front of you is the dashboard of WordPress. So what you have to do to create your blog post? So firstly guys, you have to go on post section, and after that you have to go on add new section. So guys, there after that your screen will open where you have to create your blog post, right guys? So first section is here, add title, where you have to add title or you have to give heading of your blog about what your blog is. So you have to create the heading of your blog. Guys, you can also say it is also H1 tag. It is also known as H1 tag about what I have talked to you before. It is your H1 tag. So here it is our heading. It is the heading of our blog. I have copied it and I will paste it here. So guys, it is the heading of our blog, or you can say it is H1 tag. Guys, it is already specified on WordPress and you are not required to create by your own. It is already specified by WordPress, so you are not required to create it by your own. But guys, you have to remember one thing, that all and other tags like H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6, all these tags you have to create by yourself, or you specify it according to your blog. So guys, here is our blog, or it is the content of our blog. I will copy it and I will paste it there, right guys? So I have copied it because I didn't want it to waste your time, so I have already written it. And here I will tell you that how to make use of all these things, right guys? So it is our content of our blog. And now I will tell you that how you can make use of H2 tag. What is H2 tag guys? H2 is your second heading. Like when you read a book, you see there is a chapter. So firstly your chapter name is there, so that is called first heading or H1 tag. And after that your second heading is called H2 tag. All these things you make according to yourself, right guys? So I will give this cottage in the resort as H2 tag, right? It is my second heading, right guys? So guys, when you will see the blog, you will find that the size of H1 tag or your first heading is the maximum and your second heading is little shorter than your first heading, and after that third heading more shorter than second heading. So you will find accordingly, and you can differentiate between the size of these headings, right guys? So I have given it second heading, right? Now facilities in the resort, so I will take it as my third heading, right guys? And after that dining hall is there. It is under facilities in the resort, so I have given facilities in the resort as third heading. So I will give dining hall as my H4 tag, or you can say it is your fourth heading, right? Now it is another facility, corporate groups. It is another facility. So I will also give it as 4 tag. Right guys? And things to get there. I will give it as again 3rd heading. Right guys? Then activities. Activities is my another 3rd heading. Right guys? And after that, these all are my activities, so I will give it as 4th heading, because these are under activities. Activities is 3rd heading and these all are under activities, so I will take it as 4th heading. Right guys? So jungle walks is also 4th heading. Village walks will also be my 4th heading. Right guys? And games will also be 4th heading, because these all comes under H4 tag, or these all comes under activities, so I will take it as 4th heading. Right guys? Now what you have to do, now you have to make your text justified, because your blog should look well organized. When anybody reads your blog, or when anybody comes on your blog to read it, it should look well organized, because if it will not be well organized, then it will not attract your users. So guys, it is the code for making your text justified. So I have copied from there and I will paste it here, right? Because guys, I wanted to save your time, so I have already written this code, because I wanted to save your time. I didn't want it to waste your time, and I didn't want it to make it boring for you. So I have taken it from there. Right guys? And you have to paste this code on each paragraph. Which paragraph you want to make your paragraph justified, you have to paste this code in each paragraph, or in the starting of each paragraph. Right guys? So I have pasted it in all the paragraphs, you can see. Right guys? So now, firstly guys, I want to tell you that it is visual. As you can see here, it is our blog, and where you write the code is text section. As you can see, text is here and visual is here. So in text section you write your all codes, right? As you can see. And one more thing guys, it is a code of our justify, so I have pasted in the starting of each paragraph, and you have to also close your paragraph by this. Right guys? But if you will not paste this code here, or you will not close your paragraph, it will be automatically closed by WordPress when you will paste this code in the starting of your paragraph. And when you will go on visual section, you can see it is already mentioned by WordPress there. So you your text has become justified. Right guys? So now you can see it is looking well organized. Right? You can see here it is looking well organized to you. Right? Now I will come on another section, that is our categories section. So categories is for that section guys where you want to show your blog, or you can say in which category you want to show your blog on your blog. Right guys? So I want to show this in resort category or in traveling category. I want to show my blog on resort category and traveling category, so I have ticked it here, and you can see it is showing make primary, or it is showing primary here. It means this blog will be shown on resort and traveling category. Right guys? Now we come to our keyword section. So what is your keyword? Right? So my keyword is best resort in Mukteshwar, Nainital. Right guys? It is my keyword. What does it mean? When anybody will search on Google best resort in Mukteshwar, Nainital, he will find my blog there. Right? So it is based on keyword. Guys, one more thing is there. You can see I have taken a comma here, so it is not allowing me. Right? So you cannot make use of comma there. you have to write your keyword without comma, right guys? And after that, you have to give title and description to your blog. So how you can give there? You can see snippet preview here, right? So you have to go on edit snippet, right? Here is your SEO title and you have to edit it. And I have already written my title and description. So I will copy from here and I will paste it there, right? So you can see it is according to a specified limit. But guys, as you can see, it's not according to specified limit. So you have to make it under a specified limit, right guys? You are not required to write more than a specified limit and not less than your specified limit, right guys? And after that, you have to write your description there. So I will copy my description from here and I will paste it there. As you can see, it is more than a specified limit. So you can cut this from here, right? And now you can see it is less than a specified limit. So I will do something else. I will take it as like this, right? Now I will cut this section, and even now it is not according to specified limit. So I will take it from here, the spacious cottages like stone hut etc. from here, and I will paste it there, right? And after that I will cut this from here, right? So it has become according to specified limit, right guys? As you can see, so you have to take your title and description both under a specified limit, right? So you can say your title and description title is under 55 to 60 characters, and your description is under 155 to 160 characters. So you have to write under that, right guys? So you have learned that how to give keywords, title and description. Now we come to image section. How you have to optimize your image, right guys? So firstly, I will go on Photoshop and I will tell you that how to write the name of your image, or when you will save your image, how to write the name of your image. So it is my image which I want to set as feature image, right guys? And after that, I will save this image and I will show you how you have to save your name, right? So I will press Ctrl Alt Shift plus S, and after that original and save, right guys? So I will save my image on desktop. I will save the name as Best Resort in Mukteshwar, Nainital, right guys? Guys, as you can see, I have written all the letters in lowercase or on small letters, right? So you also have to write everything in small letters or in lowercase. You can't make use of capital letters if you want to make your blog SEO friendly or you want to optimize your image. So you have to make use of small letters. And one more thing guys, you can't make use of space. There should be no space in the name of your image, right guys? So you have to write your name without a space or by making use of hyphen, right? And after that, you have to save, right? After that guys, when you will save the image, after that you have to do one thing, that you have to compress your image, right? From here, you will compress your image. You can make use of tinypng.com website. There is a website which you can use for compressing your image. Because guys, why you have to compress your image? Because when you will post your image or when you will insert your image in your blog, and when you will see that image or when you will open your blog, then when if your image is not compressed, or if the size of your image is too large, then it will take too much time in getting opened, right? So you have to compress your image, and you can take the help of tinypng.com. And I have compressed my image guys. It will take only seconds and your image is compressed. After that, you can download the image from here, right? My image is downloaded, right guys? So guys, now my image is complete and I will go again on my dashboard, right guys? So from here you have to set your featured image. Here is the featured image section and you have to click on set featured image, right? And after that you will go on upload files and you will drag your file from here, right? So guys, now you can see here our image is uploaded. And what you have to do here, you have to go on alt text and you have to go on title. How you have to give your alt text? And guys, one more thing, what is alt text? So guys, I want to tell you that alt text is that text according to which when Google crawls your image, by the help of alt text it identifies your image. Because Google doesn't know and Google can't identify what your image is all about. So it identifies your image according to your alt text. So guys, your alt text should be that which suits to your image and it tells about your image, and it should also tell what your blog is all about. So you have to give the name of your alt text, as it will specify or it will help to identify your image and your blog also, right? So I will give alt text as best resort in Mukteshwar Nainital, right guys? And after that you have to give title. What is title? Guys, when you search anything in Google, like when you will search best resort in Mukteshwar, and if my image is appearing there, so why it is appearing there? Because you have searched that title according to which my image is all about. So guys, I will give the name as best resort in Mukteshwar, right? Because I want that if anybody search about best resort in Mukteshwar Nainital, and when he goes on image section, my image should appear there, right guys? So I have given the title. It's no matter that you can give same alt text and you can give same title, and if you want, then you can use the different names for your title and for your alt text, right guys? So after that you have to set it as your featured image, right guys? Guys, I want to tell you one more thing, that if you don't know what is SEO title and what is your meta description, so I want to tell you that if you have searched resort membership in Mukteshwar Nainital on Google, then these sites are coming in front of you, right? So as you can see, resort membership in Nainital at affordable charges, this is the title which I have given here, right? Or when you will when anybody will search her Nainital, the best resort in Mukteshwar Nainital, then this page would appear here, right? This site would appear here, right? And what is description? It is description, right guys? Below title is description what we have written here, right? And I want to tell you one more thing guys, that when you are writing your h2 tag, this h2 tag, you should not make use of more than 10 h2 tag in your blog. Because if you will make use of more than 10 h2 tags in your blog, then your blog will not be SEO friendly and it will not rank on Google properly, or it will get less rank. So you have to not you should not make use of more than 10 h2 tags, right guys? And now our blog is ready. And one more thing guys, if you want to know that if you want to insert any image in middle of your blog apart from your featured image, if you want that any image should appear here below the cottages, or you want to insert any image related to cottages, then how you can do that? So you have to make use of add media, right? From here you will click on add media, and after that you will take any file from here, upload. You can upload any file from there, or you can take any files from here. So I will take this file, right guys? So same process is there as you have followed before to set your feature image. You have to follow the same process, right guys? And from here you can set the alignment of your image, and if you want then you can reduce your size, right? From here you can reduce your size or you can increase the size of your image. You can do, right guys? So I hope all these things are clear to you, right? And once you should see the preview of your blog. When you are going to publish your blog, before that you should see the preview. Before that guys, what we have to do, we have to give text to our blog. So text, what is the mean of text? Text are the keywords, right guys? Text are the keywords on which your blog is searchable. So I will give the keyword or I will give the tag as best resort in Mukteshwar Nainital. Again, a resort in Mukteshwar Nainital, right guys? My third keyword, if I want that if anybody search about her Nainital, then my blog should appear there. If anybody search about Herb Nainital Resort, then my blog should appear there, right guys? So one more keyword or one more tag, resort membership in Nainital, because guys, this resort provides the membership of the resort, or this company provides the membership of their resort. So I will also give this tag, right guys? So I think you have understood everything what we have to do. Once more I will recall you everything, right? I have told you about how to give H1 tag, right? And here I have told you that how to give your description or how to make use of H2, H3 tags, H4 tags. All these things I have told you, right guys? I have also told you that how to make your content justified, right? And after that I have told you that how to give your keywords, title and description, right? Your title and your description, I have told you that you have to give here. I have told you about categories. You can select your categories from here, in which category you want to publish your blog or you want to show your blog. From here you can give text to your blog, right? And after that here featured image, and here your another image, which another image you want to show on your blog, you can take it from ad media. I hope guys all these things are clear, and from here you can see the preview before publishing. So to make sure that everything is well organized and everything is looking very good in your blog, so here you can see how your blog is looking, right guys? So as you can see here, your blog is looking well organized, so you can publish it from here, right? I hope guys that you have understood how to create a SEO friendly blog post in your WordPress. And guys, if you have any doubts and any queries related to this, then please you can ask us on comment section. I will definitely reply you and I will definitely try to resolve all your problems. Guys, if you like my video, then please press the like button, and if you want to get the latest video updates of my channel, then please do subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. Thank you so much for watching this video guys.